go to the project page and click View Data. Wait a moment for the data to load. This may take a few minutes for very large data sets, and it depends on your internet connection speed. While it's loading, this is me collecting a few more data points from two tomato plants so we would have something to play with. If you're taking images for each leaf, you can collect about 50 measurements per hour. If you're not, you can collect closer to 80 measurements per hour. Pretty fast. All right, the data's done loading. This is the Data Explorer. It's a powerful tool with lots of features. I'm just going to describe a few to get you started. First, let's find our data point. We'll start by creating a new series to filter the data. Click Add. You can see all the questions we answered when we collected the data, along with time, devices, and collaborators. Let's find our name and hit Add. Delete the whole dataset series. Don't worry, we never ever actually delete data. We're just deleting it from this particular session. Now, back to series. Okay, so let's find our specific data point. We can plot our data by time by clicking on the plot icon, plot data, and choosing time on the X, and how about light intensity on the Y? Great, here's the date range I collected the data. Click to see details. This is right, I think we found it. Now let's make sure I collected the data correctly. I tried to collect three data points at each leaf location, top, middle, and bottom, in that order. Let's put leaf number on the Y and zoom in. Wow, it looks pretty good, actually. Let's also check the map. Yep, I chose two different tomato plants located in different garden plots. Using the Data Explorer, you can actually confirm the data was collected at the right time, in the right order, at the right location, and so on. This is particularly important for a project creator to ensure data quality. Now let's do something more interesting. We'll put light intensity on the X and Phi2 on the Y. This is exactly the graph we expect. Photosynthetic efficiency goes down as intensity goes up. But I see an outlier. Let's check it out. No fluorescent signal, and the leaf appears in pretty bad shape. We can flag this data point if we think it isn't appropriate. Let's see what the project directions say about dead leaves. This project explicitly says we shouldn't measure a dead leaf, so we'll flag it accordingly. Be careful when flagging to always have a good reason. An outlier could be the most interesting data point in your whole project, so only flag data if you're confident that there was an actual error during the data collection. As always, if you're unsure, post your concerns to the project forum. Now let's compare the different leaf locations, top, middle, and bottom. Go add a new series for top, middle, and bottom, and delete our current series. You can select several answers and add them at the same time using the Import a Separate Series option. Now go to Plot Data, and let's compare averages for these groups. Start with light intensity. Leaves on the bottom of the plant see less light. That makes sense. Now let's compare across different species. Now let's see leaf temperature. How about leaf angle? There's a large range, so let's view it as a histogram. I can do this all day, but you get the idea.